Welcome, students. Welcome for my next video, Standard 9th History, Changing Life, Part 1. Now, my dear students, before I start with the video, or before I start with the chapter, it's a sincere request to you. Please like the video and also subscribe it. Not only like and subscribe, but also share it among your friends so that all the others also could benefit this video. Yes, my dear students, we will see now how in our day-to-day life, right from our pre-independence period till today, how the life pattern is changing. That we are going to witness it in this lesson. Haan, mere priya vidyarthiyon, is part mein hum dekhenge कि हमारा जीवन जो है बहुत से परिवर्तन हो रहा है. अगर हम देखेंगे आज़ादी, हमारे देश को आज़ादी मिलने से पहले हमारे जीवन कैसा था, आज़ादी मिलने के बाद हमारा जीवन कैसा है, ये सब हमें इस पार्ट में दिखाई देगा. आइए हम लोग इस पार्ट को और गहराई से उसको सीखें और उसका अध्ययन करें. इन दिस लेसन वी आर मोस्टली गोइंग टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन द इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ फैमिली, सोशल वेलफेयर, Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribes, Public Health, Kidney Transplant, Test Tube Baby Immunization, Urbanization, Post-Independent Period. We will see changing economic life, social needs and facilities, how in the rural areas the electricity supply is there, and industrial development. Let us see how and why there was a change in our life pattern. What was our life during the pre-independence period? And what is the life now? Now, as we all know, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, who is considered to be a person who has a lion's share in making the constitution. As we all know, he is considered to be the father, or he is considered to be a person who has a lion's share in the constitution. According to our constitution, in India, we all are equal. The laws are such that there is no discrimination on the basis of religion, race, caste, gender, or place of birth. We all have got rights, certain rights like freedom of speech and expression. We can speak We can give our opinion, but we cannot give bad words to others. We cannot use offending words towards others. Freedom of assembly and to assemble peacefully. Like if you are doing a puja or you are celebrating any festival, you have freedom of assembly, but you cannot be a nuisance to others. Freedom to move from one place to another. Freedom to settle somewhere in the part of the country. In any part of our country or in Indian territory. हम लोग देखेंगे हमारे संविधान में सबके लिए एक जैसा नियम बनाया गया है, चाहे वो गोरा हो या काला, चाहे वो लंबा हो या नाटा, चाहे वो पैसे वाला हो या गरीब, सबके लिए नियम एक है। हम देखेंगे तो किसी को भी हम पक्षपात नहीं कर रहे हैं क्योंकि वो हिंदू है, ये मुसलमान है, वो सिख है, ये ईसाई है, ना वो लड़का है, ये लड़की है, वो उस प्रांत में पैदा हो गया है, वो इस प्रांत में पैदा हुआ है। हम ऐसे पक्षपात करते नहीं हैं। हमें पूरी आज़ादी है, हम किसी भी हमारे देश के किसी भी कोने में हम जा सकते हैं, रह सकते हैं, काम कर सकते हैं। अगर हमें पूजा पाठ करनी है, हमें प्रार्थना करनी है तो भी हम कर सकते हैं। हमें किसी जगह रह के रहना है जहां शांति है, जहां अशांत वातावरण नहीं है, हम वहां जाकर रह सकते हैं। लेकिन हमारे भारत में केवल भारत में हम रह सकते हैं। Now as we know that our society give importance to family. Family is identified as an important or very, very important institution of Indian society. India was known all over the world as a country who was very famous for a joint family. And because of globalization, now this joint family is split into smaller families that was called as nuclear family. हाँ मेरे प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, हम लोग देखेंगे परिवार एक अभिन्न अंग था हमारे समाज का। बिना परिवार के हम हमारे समाज के बारे में सोच ही नहीं सकते थे। और हमारा भारत देश केवल एक ही था जो बड़े कुटुंब के लिए जाना जाता था, बड़ा परिवार। लेकिन जिस तरह परिवर्तन आया हमारे परिवारों में, अभी जितना बड़ा परिवार था पहले, अब एक छोटा परिवार हो गया है जिसमें बाप, माता पिता और उनके बच्चे, अब दादा दादी, चाचा चाची, मामा मामी, उनके लिए जगह नहीं रह गया। सब केवल अपने परिवार तक सीमित रखा गया है। सोशल वेलफेयर, देयर आर सोशल वेलफेयर प्रोग्राम्स that make opportunities for full-time employment like healthcare, education, development for citizens. Indian society is riddled with large-scale economic, social, educational and cultural inequalities. On 14 June 1964, Government of India constituted Ministry of Social Welfare. Under this ministry, they were given responsibility for nutrition and child development and social security and social protection. Education for all was the motto. Scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. My dear students, according to 1971 census, 22% of the people belong to scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. As we all know, scheduled caste and scheduled tribes were treated very badly right from the pre-independence period. In the post-independence period, what did they do? Various amendments was made in the constitution and laws were enacted where the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes were given preference in education, in jobs, they were given scholarships, as well as in the parliament and assemblies, they were given representation. Some seats are reserved for them in even in the government services. Public health, as we all know, is the primary duty of the government to raise the people's standard of living, to ensure proper nutrition. And for this, you require to improve public health. Progress in the medical field has made the life of Indians relatively free of health concerns. Yes, my dear students, I would like to give examples. In the pre-independence period, many children were dying of cholera, polio, diphtheria, smallpox, chickenpox. But, my dear students, now, the time has come where there are vaccines and the vaccines are taking care of all these diseases. So public health now has it has been improved. And now the birth rate is more and the death rates are less because all the vaccines are there and the public health has improved. In 1962, there was successful heart surgery was performed. Now we will see related to kidney transplantation. Many surgeries were not so common in India till 1971. But in 1971, successfully performed a kidney transplantation at Christian College, Medical College at Vellore in Tamil Nadu. Dr. Johnny and Dr. Mohan Rao transplanted kidney donated by a living person into the patient's body. So nowadays, patients come to India from underdeveloped countries for such surgeries. Mere priya vidyarthiyo, hum log dekhenge vaidyakiya chikitsa pehle bahut durlabh tha. Sabhi ko vaidyakiya chikitsa nahi mil raha tha. Ab dekhenge ke logo ki aayu bahut badh gayi hai. Karan kya hai? कारण केवल एक ही है, वैद्यकीय चिकित्सा हमको मिल रहा है. पहले चिकनगुनिया, चिकन पॉक्स, स्मॉल पॉक्स, ये सब के लिए दवा नहीं था, लेकिन अभी वो है. पोलियो के लिए दवा है. अब इसके लिए जो आयु है लोगों का, किसी व्यक्ति का अब बहुत बढ़ गया है। कारण केवल एक है, चिकित्सा जो उपलब्ध हो रही है इससे सभी का आयु बढ़ रहा है। टेस्ट ट्यूब बेबी, एज वी ऑल नो, पीपल इन इंडिया, मेनी कपल्स, दे क्राई दैट दे डोंट हैव चिल्ड्रन। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी ऑलवेज फाइंड Nowadays, that problem is solved. It's because of the support of test tube baby technology, which was available to the childless couple in the year 1978. It was conducted under Dr. Subhash Mukhopadhyay. He experimented the test tube baby and it was a successful attempt at artificial conception. This technology has helped to solve the problem of childless couples who wanted children. Immunization. As we all know, immunization, this word immunization we are very familiar with. Before 1978, every year 6 Indian infant or children or child out of 10 who were born had fatal health problems in very first year of their birth and they die. The immunization program has taken up and they have overcome the threat of polio, measles, tetanus, TB, diphtheria, whooping cough. Pulse polio immunization program has started in 1995 that has controlled polio in India. Tremendous progress has been made. Urbanization. Now when I speak of urbanization, if I'll ask you, where do you want to live? You will not prefer rural village, but you all like urbanization. Then the question arises, why do you like urbanization? Because in urbanization, there are a lot of facilities available. Now we all are living in Mumbai. Now why are we living in Mumbai? Because there are a lot of facilities. There are facilities for education. There are electricity which is available. Transport and communication is available. Water is available. There is economic activity going on in Mumbai. You are getting jobs and there are well social organizations and the community life is very well organized. So you feel like staying in urban areas. Now, my dear students, let us see. In the rural life, what happens in the rural life? We don't prefer to stay in rural life because in rural areas, we don't get facilities of what we get in the urban area. Yes, my dear students, in rural areas, if you want to go to a market, you need to walk at least 5 kilometers. If you want to go to school, you have to walk and then take a bus and then reach to the school. All the facilities are not available. There is no electricity. There is no proper transport and communication. As a result of this, why the people, they don't prefer to stay in rural life or in rural areas. And rural areas, who prefer then? It is very, very clear. Those people like farmers, those who follow the occupation of farming, they prefer rural life. Now we'll see the post-independence period. Plans have been made for improving farming technology, increasing the area of irrigated land, extending educational facilities, enacting law for land reforms under the schemes. It also aimed in increasing agricultural produce, expanding the means of transport, health service, scope of education. The government has undertook this work through the medium of Gram Panchayat and Zila Parishad. And in the urban area, they take the help of municipality. Changing economic life. Now, as we all know, majority of the people are living in village. They are dependent on farming. Farm produce are used to distribute among the artisans as a payment of their work. Now the situations have changed. Rural areas are engaged in agriculture and occupation, but also ancillary a substitute to the farming. Like there are service sectors and in agricultural production. Rural development. In 1961, 82% of the people or Indian population resides in village. In 1971, percentage has come down to 80.1. The people are now moving from rural areas to urban areas. And why? Because in search of job, in search of progress in their life. There are three main challenges why in the rural development. You know, the three main challenges are to bringing about economic development, developing facilities for social needs, and finally changing of attitude of the culture and different ways of thinking. Now I would like to tell you, my dear students, please don't think that the people in the rural village, they are backward. No. Even they have got internet. They have got satellite TVs. They have got satellite links. And no more they are using bullocks. But they are using all the ultra modern facilities which are available in Europe. Our rural situations are changing. The rural village is changing. All the facilities which are there, the televisions, are there even in the rural village. The only thing is, they are in the remote part. Otherwise, whatever the facilities which are there in urban areas, we find the same facility even in the rural areas. Social needs and facilities. Like it is necessary to give priority to the facilities like public hygiene, health care. The collective department schemes have had important place in first 4 or 5 year plans of the government of India. The state of Maharashtra registered remarkable achievement under the scheme. For example, Zila Parishad were established in 1962. Nutrition diet scheme was launched under the scheme in 1970 and 71. Rural water supply has started for sinking wells and providing piped water. Rural electrification. My dear students, now no more, I told you, there are no more, the rural village is no more backward. You will find electricity over there. And why they are taking electricity? For automatic pumps, they require to pump water in the field. Electricity is required to preserve perishable food items like milk, egg, fruits, vegetables, to run fertilizer projects, and for fans and TVs and the lights, and for studying at night. My dear students, now we will see industrial development. As we all know that in the 5 year plans, government prefer to encourage industries. So the village industry planning committee was established to help the development of industry in rural areas. By 1972, 1,06,000 persons got employment under the scheme. The government of Maharashtra has also started residential schools known as Vidya Niketan in Satara, Aurangabad, Nasik, Chikledara. Their purpose is to provide best quality education to the intelligent and meritorious village students. UNESCO awarded International Prize for the Spread of Literacy to Maharashtra in 1972. Thank you, my dear students. My dear students, once again, a sincere request. Please do like the video, subscribe it, and share it among others. मेरे प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, आपसे अनुरोध है कि आप इस वीडियो को लाइक करें, उसको सब्सक्राइब करें और ये वीडियो दूसरे के साथ बांटें। I wish you all the best, my dear students.